Welcome to GrayYeon Math. We are asked to solve this problem. Given dimensions are AB is equal to 13, AC is equal to 15, BC is equal to 14, AD is the height of triangle ABC, and the area of AEFB is equal to the area of AFEC. Find EF. But before we go to the solution, may I request you to please like this video. And also, you can pause for a moment or to write in the comment section a solution for this problem. Okay, so first thing that we need to do is we need to find the semi-perimeter of this triangle. So for the semi-perimeter, S is equal to 13 plus 14. Plus 15 over 2. So on the numerator, it gives us 42. So S is equal to 42 over 2. Okay, S is equal to 21. Okay, so next thing that we need to do is we need to find the area of triangle ABC using Heron's formula. So the area is equal to the square root of the same perimeter, which is 21, times 21 minus one side is 13, and 21 again minus 14, and 21 again minus 15, and this gives us area equal to the square root of 21. Times 8, times 7, times 6. And this gives us area is equal to 21 times, but if you multiply 6 and 7, it will give you 42 times 8. So if you rearrange the factors, then if you divide this 42 by writing it as 2 times 21, and this becomes 21, same, then this becomes 8. So if you combine this 8 times 2, this becomes 16, but 16 is actually 4 squared, the square root of 4 squared times 21 squared. So the area will give you is equal to square root of 21 square times 4 square is equal to 21 times 4. Area is equal to 84 square units. Okay, next thing that we need to do is we need to find the length of AD. So we know that the area is equal to 84, and that is equal to 1/2 times the base, which is BC, times AD. So AD is equal to 84 times 2 over BC. BC is equal to 14. So 84 divided by 14 is equal to 6. So AD is equal to 12 units. Okay, so next thing that we have to do is we need to find the length of BD. BD is equal to the square root of AB square minus AD square, because AD and BD are two perpendicular segments and they form a right triangle with the length AB. So BD is equal to the square root of 13 square minus 12 square. So We can simplify this by 13 minus 12 times 13 plus 12. This becomes 1, and this becomes 25. So square root of 25 is equal to 5 units. Okay, so next thing that we need to do is we need to find the area of AEFD, which is actually this area. And it is actually a trapezoid. And area is equal to AEFD, equal to the area of this blue region. And that blue region is actually equal to 84 divided by 2, because it is actually half of the area of the full triangle, which is given, because area of AEFB is equal to area of FEC. So we need to subtract the area of this triangle ADB, and the area of ADB is equal to 1/2 times BD, which is 5. This is the base of this right triangle, 5, and the height, which is 12, as we have calculated earlier the value of AD. So this becomes 12. So area AEFD is equal to 42. This becomes 42. And this becomes 30. So the area is equal to 12 square units. Okay, so next thing is we need to label the lengths. So we know that BD is actually 5 units. So this would be 5. And BD is equal to 12. And this DC is actually 14 minus 5, which is 9. And these lengths, we don't know yet, these two lengths. But we can label that as, this could be, we can label this as Y. And this FC as 9 minus Y. And we can label EF as X. Okay, so next is we consider the fact that triangle ABC is similar to triangle EFC. And by doing so, we can make an equation about that. And this becomes, for triangle ABC, we can say that 12 over 9 is equal to, for triangle EFC, we can say that this is X all over 9 minus Y. That would be our equation 1. And for the next equation is we need to use the area of triangle EFC, and that is 42. Because it is half of the area of the whole triangle, is equal to 1/2 times the base, which is 9 minus y, times the height, which is x. That would be equation 2. Okay, so next is we simplify the first equation. So 12 over 9 is equal to x over 9 minus y. 9 minus y is equal to 9 over 12, which is equal to 3/4. So that becomes 3/4 x 9 minus y. Okay, so next thing that we need to do is we need to use the second equation and substitute the value of 9 minus y to the second equation, and we have 42 is equal to 1 half times 9 minus 1 times x. 42 is equal to 1 half times 3 over 4 times x. Times x. Then, if we divide this by 3, 42, this becomes 14. And we cancel this 3. And 14 times 8 will become 112. 112 is equal to x squared. If we get the square root of 112, this will give us the value of x. Then this can be written as x is equal to the square root of 16 times 7, or x is equal to 4 square root of 7 units. And that is our answer. Okay, so please write on the comment section for any solution that you may have for this problem. Please like the video if you like our solution. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon so you will be updated for more math videos like this. Thank you. Bye.